Hi folks, I hope Cyclone Fani, or Phoni as it has been called, has left you unscathed. The election fever has also not caused you fever. And in all of this time, I met a lady. As I was talking to her, I realized the various dimensions that women hold in our lives today. Women are providers for us in the house. Women go out into the workplace and do the best, breaking many glass ceilings today. This lady is a doctor. She takes care of our patients. She looks after her family whenever she gets her time being away from her family. And then she cooks. I decided to invite her to the Bong Mom's Kitchen, although she's not a mom as yet, but definitely I'm sure she will be one soon. And she epitomizes all the qualities that the Bong Moms demonstrate. So without much ado, let me call in my Otithi today. My Otithi is Dr. Tonoya Paja. Tonoya, please welcome to my show today.
Hi.
Hi. So this is Dr. Tonoya Paja. Tonoya is a surgeon, an ENT surgeon.
Yeah.
Okay. So Tonoya is an ENT surgeon. She passed out her master's in surgery last year,
last year.
And now she is working in a government hospital, Chandanagar. Chandanagar Subdivisional Hospital is part of her obligations towards the government as a post-master's postmaster's obligation, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So that's what she does. And you're basically not from Calcutta, I understand.
No, my native place is in Tomluk.
So she's in Midnapur, the southern part of Bengal.
Yeah.
And she lives here. So manages life for her own self, manages her.
I live in Behala, basically. I stay in Behala and I...
And manages her patients' lives.
Yeah.
Right? And in all of this, she loves cooking, I understand, right? So Tonoya, what are your interests? Like you said, you are an ENT surgeon, right? So ear, nose, throat. And anything you are specializing in terms of?
I have a special interest in ear surgery, but okay. I want to pursue it further.
Okay.
Let's see what...
I understand that a lot of work is being done here in Kolkata in terms of cochlear implants and those kind of stuff.
It's in my college only.
Okay.
So cochlear implant is being done under the central government guidance.
Okay. So I understand people who have been born deaf or something like that, they are being able to now hear with this kind of a cochlear implant.
Hmm.
Maybe you could throw us some light on this while we are cooking. While we are cooking, not right now, but while we are cooking, right?
No, basically that is a congenital deafness. Congenital deafness that is inborn.
So the person is inborn with
inborn,
deafness.
Inborn, deaf and dumb.
Okay.
Those people, there is a lot of social stigma.
Okay.
To understand that.
That they cannot hear, they cannot talk.
So cochlear implant gives them a life to carry further. Like.
Wonderful. Wonderful. So people who have never been able to hear anything or have never been able to speak, thanks to people like Tonoya, they are probably able to...
Now the central government is providing a scheme.
Okay.
Under that, cochlear implant is being done in a free.
Okay.
And in
so like I said, so these people are being able to give, being given a new lease of life through the efforts of the central government along with doctors like Tonoya. Who are
the senior doctors are there who actually do. We are the assistants. We are much junior.
She's just being modest.
No. We are just juniors and seniors.
So Tanaya, what are we cooking today?
This is authentic Bengali dish. This is potolel dorma.
Okay.
It's called dorma or dorma as you call.
Okay.
And it is...
So this is potol is basically kind of a gourd.
Ha.
Right? So I see you've got these gourds which you have hollowed out already, right?
Yeah.
So you've already hollowed it out. So
no, the
seeds have been hollowed out,
seeds
right?
Seeds have been hollowed out, and the this has been
the flesh. The skin has been peeled off.
Peeled off, not
right.
fully.
Fully, but the basic covering is
Yeah.
off, and you have
Curated the seeds
seeds
and put
which
it in.
you kept there. So what is this?
This is chhena.
This is chhena. Chhena is your curdled milk. Okay, fine.
Yes.
Then that is I guess
tomato
paste. This is onion paste.
Onion paste,
ginger paste,
paste, garlic,
garlic
paste.
Paste.
These are some whole spices.
Okay, this is your whole cumin. That's your
cardamom,
clove, and cinnamon.
Cinnamon.
This is your
coriander
leaves.
That is for mostly garnishing. This
okay.
is green chili paste.
Wow.
And this one is okay. We'll tell later.
This is basically, I understand, a little bit of flour that you kneaded into
to seal the
to seal
this,
it. Right. Wonderful. And I see some more ground spices
basic,
also,
masala,
which is your salt,
yeah.
garam masala, jeera powder, which is your cumin powder. This is your
turmeric powder,
red chili
red
powder,
chili.
And coriander.
Mm-hmm.
Wonderful. Wonderful. So
and of course oil.
Of course oil. So let's get started.
Yeah.
Right. So let me go boom. What kind of oil are you using? Are you using mustard oil or
yes, mustard oil.
You using mustard oil?
Yes.
Wonderful. Bengali food is incomplete without mustard oil.
Yes.
What? And so we go, boom. There we are. Shall I pour oil for you? Let it heat up first.
Okay, put the oil
there. Tell me how much.
This is for the making of the
Stuffing.
Stuffing.
You need more?
No.
So basically what we'll be doing is we'll first prepare a stuffing. Then we'll stuff the gourd with the stuffing.
Yes.
And then we'll make a gravy out of it, right?
Yes.
Okay, wonderful. So let's get started. What do we start with? The
spice
seeds,
first.
Okay, the whole spices.
We need the seeds and the chhena for the stuffing.
Okay.
And put the whole this cumin powder. Cumin
Wonderful.
First.
Okay, so we'll start. You're putting it on medium heat, right?
Yes.
So this is what is called foron or photon in the for you to start off
yes.
The cooking of it. Okay, so. The whole cumin only first. The rest you will not use?
Yes, I'll use
during the gravy. Okay. So this is the seeds that you have curated out.
Soften a bit.
Okay.
Because the chhena is a half cooked thing. This
okay,
will not
it's
take
already,
much time to be cooked.
It's already done.
So this will be a bit fried, and I put the chhena in. And also that
she'll make it. You'll just stir fry it, basically.
Kind of. Put some salt in it, so that
there is a taste in it. So what do you do in your spare time, Sonaya? What are your hobbies?
There are lots of things, like I love reading storybooks.
Okay.
I love singing.
Don't you get enough of reading while for your work?
Mm-hmm.
Don't you get enough of reading for your work? I'm sure you have to read a lot of books, a lot of journals to keep abreast of whatever is happening. And then you find some more time to read? Reading has
no,
become a passion?
I don't get a lot of time to read, basically. But still, I like... Till now, I like those fairy tales.
Oh, fairy tales? You love to go back to your childhood,
yeah?
Stay connected with your child. If only we could all go back to our childhood, to the times of Cinderella and Peter Pan, to find a Prince Charming waiting for us, for a lady like Tonaya.
No.
Or be able to fly like Peter Pan and go into the Neverland. A little bit of ginger.
And also the horror stories, suspense stories.
Okay.
Still,
so I mean,
Tona,
are you bipolar? Because
no.
You are at one end, you are at fairy tales, and the other end, you are at horror stories.
No, not like that.
And how about some reality like thrillers and politics? to keep you grounded in between.
Politics not at all, but thrillers are like.
Yeah, so there's a just mild balancing of thrillers in your spectrum of reading, because at the one end of the pole you've got fantasy of fairy tales, and the other end you've got horror stories. Wonderful. So how do you know that this is being cooked ready right now? Because for example, if you're trying to cook something, you try to see whether it is softened up. Here the seeds are anyways going to be hard. So how do you know that it is cooked up? You're just feeling it out, that the crunch will tell you that it is done. Right, wonderful.
Now I'm putting the chana in it.
Okay.
How much
stuffing that you want to make.
You have to like,
so let us take for example, this is good for how many guards?
Four.
This is four. So four. Basically you are cooking for two, for a portion of for two people, right?
And another thing is that the chena, amount of chena will be more than the seeds.
Obviously.
The seeds will be a bit crunchy.
It is the core maybe that will make it.
Don't put seeds in it.
Okay.
But I have.
It's your innovation.
My technique.
Your innovation.
Yeah.
So that you
not
get
a very,
you get traditional cook.
No, not at all.
You're not. You're an innovator.
Not an innovator.
Helps during a surgery being able to innovate. Or do you always have to be a copybook person?
Actually, everything is about balance.
So essentially, it is more or less sorted out, right?
No, not fully. The chena is still whitish.
So it'll go yellowish.
So I'll put some salt because I had put the salt in proportion to the seeds.
See, now you're adding the way.
So
surgery, is it very copybook or I'm sure
no.
it is a lot of pressure for you people when you're doing it, because under your scalpel you've got a person's, this is your green chili paste, right? Okay, so under the scalpel you've got a person's life probably in hand, right? So I'm sure that's a lot of pressure, right?
Yes, but
so I mean at that point of time, what is more comforting, being doing something on a copybook manner or being the ability to be able to innovate and
It depends on the situation, basically. According to situation, you have to modify.
Right. So being able to modify and adapt is a very critical aspect of being a good surgeon, right?
Being a good doctor also.
Okay. I'm sure every patient is unique.
Yes.
Every
nothing
patient
is
unique. Every patient is unique in his own way or her own way.
Every surgery is unique. Like ear surgery, we do by mastoid surgery. Every mastoid surgery.
What is a mastoid surgery? Mastoid is a bone. I understand, right?
It is the bone behind the ear. Basically, some disease affects the
that bone.
Yeah, that is called COM. Colitis.
We don't want to know all of that. We don't want to know all of that. But basically, what I get to understand is that as a doctor, you have to be very abreast with whatever is there in the books. But at the same time, you've also got to keep an open mind to be able to innovate and modify your approach
keep
towards.
Keep the normal, keep the common things first in mind.
Okay, what did you add, by the way?
The coriander powder and cumin powder.
Okay.
So you have to keep the common things in mind, but also you have to keep the rarest possibility
in
mind.
Okay. So you have to be able to modify. So this is almost done.
I just put some tomato puree in it, a spoon or two just
to give the tangy.
I said this is not a conventional thing, okay?
Okay.
Those people who are
but tell me something, you are a bong, you have come to a bong mom's kitchen and you have not added any kind of sugar sweet into this, how is it possible?
For you.
Okay, I mean you would normally have added or you would not have added?
No, I would have added because
okay.
This
so it's not for me, it's basically for the cooking only, right?
No, basically this needs to be added for the balance,
okay.
Sugar balance is the whole thing. And as you are talking, surgery is all about balance.
It's all about balance, right? I had another doctor who was saying something like that it is all about keeping things in checks and balances.
Every in every step, we have to see the whole scenario and then decide what to do.
Okay.
Just a few seconds and then I turn the gas off for and keep it aside. So you have to first cool it and then stuff it.
Once you stuff it, will you fry the guards again?
Yes, I seal it and see one thing. I have
you made it open only in one side.
Yeah, and the other side
it is like, already sealed.
Yeah, but see the difference. Like in one side, it is this is like cut in a distance.
Right.
So that it doesn't spill off.
I got you.
Okay. Almost
done. Okay. So we'll put it aside here.
Yeah.
Can you take a taste of how the filling tastes right now?
Okay. You can check just the seasoning also.
So when I come to have it, I'm getting the soft paneer taste and my teeth are also crunching against the seeds.
Okay.
But as you said, there's more of the chena as compared to the seeds, so it's not hurting so much. So now, Tana, you've got the guards ready, so we'll be stuffing it in, right?
Yes.
Okay. Nothing feels better than hand for us,
yes.
Indians.
Us Bengalis.
Indians. It should not such that it doesn't burst out.
Yeah.
So balance again, right? Something you've honed up.
Life is about balance.
So something that you've honed up in the operating theatres, right? So, and after that, you're going to be stuffing it off with, like sealing it off with that dough, right?
After I finish this thing.
And then you're going to fry it, right? Is it going to be a shallow fry or a deep fry?
This is going to be shallow fry.
Shallow.
Because
basically what you need to do is you just need to cook this part of the guard only, just the shell, nothing else. Because inside is anyways cooked.
Softened a bit, so that the gravy doesn't take much time to be
come into the...
Because I will make the gravy, put it in, give it some time and then...
Just to steam it up. So what kind of music do you like, Tona? You were saying you said you like music also, right? Along with reading, you like music. What else do you like? Traveling?
Anthem. Definitely.
Okay.
So
what calls you more? The hills, the
sea.
The sea,
yeah.
The forests.
The sea. Forest, I have not gone into much.
So didn't you think about going towards the sea during this onslaught of the phony? It would have been a wonderful sight, wouldn't it? Your duties, doctor had duties.
And
but wouldn't it have been amazing? It wouldn't have been an amazing experience, right? Isn't it?
One thing that I have kept up place
open for you to put the to plug it in with
Maida paste.
So this is it. So that's.
Second one, I'm showing off again. This upper part is I have kept empty.
Empty.
So that I can fill it with the
dough.
Just the consistency, you have to keep it in mind.
That it is not liquidy, watery.
No. And it is
to be
hard
thin.
Also.
It has to be thick, basically. But not hard.
Not hard. So that is one crucial step.
Basically a gooey mix, basically.
Kind of.
Our kids used to play something called Play-Doh. It looks just like that. So that's ready?
Yeah.
So now we are ready to go and fry this, right?
Yes.
Okay. So I'll put this aside and we'll go boom again.
Yes.
So I'll go ahead and add the oil. Tell me how much is enough.
Yes. Put some more.
Put some more?
Yeah.
So we'll add up. So you'll put them all in together?
Huh.
All six?
Yes. There's enough space in the pan.
Oh, okay.
And covered. I've kept it in steam. Covered. Okay.
So this is almost done?
Yeah, it's almost done. Let's put up the gas.
Okay. we'll keep it here. Just hold it here.
Golden brown color, yeah, and
yeah,
the consistency,
it's
softened up.
It's softened up, yeah.
Okay.
Right.
It's done completely.
So now you'll be making the gravy?
Yeah. The okay. Gravy. You can use the same oil.
Oh, okay, great. So what I'll do is I'll bring this back here and I'll put it on again. And boom, number 3 coming up right here. Boom. This is anyways hot.
Yeah. Okay, I'll put the whole spices. No, I'll first put the sugar for caramelization.
Okay.
The sugar. Then the whole spices.
Starting with the cardamom. Just opening them up a little bit.
The whole spices, then the masala paste.
Okay. But tell me, I was asking this to the other doctor also who had come to my show. How fulfilling is... I understand that during your internships, where you were PGT, so I understand that you have a very difficult schedule, 18 hours, 16 hours, continuous work. Right? Mm-hmm. So at the end of the day, isn't it very difficult for you people?
No. It feels like fulfilling, kind of.
So when you see the smiles of your patients, that you feel you've cured. More than cured, I guess, healed.
Mm-hmm.
Because healing is as much about the psychological aspect about as about the actual physical ailment, isn't it? The smell of the onion frying is coming through right now, and there is a very faint whiff of the whole garam masala that has been added. So that's your garlic paste now. One more thing, this is you making it with chena. I understand this can also be made as a non-veg preparation where
with
you
prawns,
put in
with chicken
prawn,
also.
Chicken, caviar, caviar, fish. Anything you can mash it up and make
it's all about like your choice.
Basically you're making a mince out of it as a filling use either shrimp or you use minced meat.
Anything.
Or caviar. Or you could just make an anda burji also maybe. And do it if you are in a hurry or something like that.
And often people just put this kind of fried parwal, they call it as potole dorma. But they don't even make the gravy also.
Okay.
Like the gravy can be made veg also. Like
without adding ginger and...
without adding onion
onion and garlic. Because in India, there's a lot of veg and non-veg to be taken into consideration.
A lot of taboos.
Yeah.
Because we Bengalis don't take ginger,
the garlic and onion
as
veg.
But the Marwaris take.
They take it, yeah. So depending on your culture.
How much you need to.
Exactly.
As I've said, I'm not a very regular cook.
So you innovate as per your tastes and your whims.
Whims, basically whims, mostly.
I hope you are not whimsical with your patients.
No, not at all. Not at all,
right?
Not at all.
Your hypocritic oath will stop you from being whimsical.
That is what I'm very serious about.
I mean, tell me something. Are you doctors? Do you imbibe that Hippocratic Oath in you? At any point of time, are you able to recite your Hippocratic Oath or is
yes,
that?
Yes, during the internship.
You have to do that, I understand.
Yes.
But I'm saying, as you go through your journey as a doctor, do you keep referring to that Hippocratic Oath? Are you doing as per what you had sworn during the oath, that you will not do this, you will not do that?
One thing, the Hippocratic Oath is all about your idealism. So if your own idealism is right,
correct.
So
You don't need to refer it back. Basic condiments, salt,
according to the amount of gravy I need, turmeric, these are the basic things,
coriander, okay, you are going to red chili powder,
Kashmiri mirch basically, for the color mostly.
Yeah, you added the green chili paste for the kick of the spice, right?
Yeah.
So you don't need the red chili powder for the kick. You all only need it for the color. That's your coriander, right?
This is cumin.
Okay, this is cumin, and that is coriander.
Coriander less. Cumin.
Very less. Okay.
And I'll add some sugar.
Sugar. Some more? Wonderful. How can we cook in a Bong Mom's kitchen without a little bit more of sugar?
A bit.
Just a bit.
Just a bit.
Just to humor people that I've added some sweet into it.
Yes.
Sweetness and love, the best ingredients to make anything tasty, isn't it, Tonan? Love and sweetness. Manage the heat.
Love what are you doing? Whatever it is in your life.
Yeah. You have to love it.
Yeah.
So when Mr. Modi starts talking about a lot of things, he does that because he loves that. And Mr. Rahul Gandhi starts... When Mr. Rahul Gandhi starts calling Mr. Modi a chowkidar is a chore, he does it because he loves calling Mr. Modi a chore. Or you are saying that he loves calling him a chore, that's why he does it that way. So there's so much conviction in his voice.
The oil is starting to separate. It will take some more time.
So why don't you sing something for us while you're cooking?
Okay, I'll put the parvals in gravy.
Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. So it's starting to separate now, right?
Yes, almost fried. I'll put some water in it.
I'll add water.
Yeah.
There you go. That's enough?
No.
You'll add more?
Yeah. Bas.
So balancing it out again, when you are putting them in, summer. Everything is about balance for you, right?
Yes.
There you go. So what is the kind of music that you like? You were saying you were going to sing for me now, right? So what is the kind of music that you like?
Mostly like Ravindra Sangeet.
Oh, wonderful.
As a bong.
As a bong, you have to laugh. Everybody, and most of the people who have come here to my show and who say that they love music are people who say that they enjoy Rabindranath. I mean, of course, for a Bengali, I think we are bred into Rabindranath, not just born into it. We understand Rabindranath better than anything else, probably.
I mean, there is Rabindranath for any kind of
any emotion that you have. There's something or the other for that.
There are one or two things. Like, then how come a person write so many things in his lifetime, I don't know. I wonder.
So what are you going to sing for me?
Okay. Ravindra Sangeet. It tells about the puja.
ওকে
আমার রাত পোহালো সারদক
ওকে
আমার রাত পোহালো শারদ প্রাতে আমার রাত পোহালো বাঁশি বাঁশি তোমায় দিয়ে যাব কাহার হাতে আমার রাত পোহালো তোমার বুকে বাজলো ধ্বনি বিদায় গাথা আগমনি কত যে ফাল্গুনে শ্রাবণে কত প্রভাতে রাতে আমার রাত পোহালো শারদ প্রাতে আমার রাত পোহালো
Wonderful. But I think it's more than a song for the Durga Puja. I think it is more a song for bereavement, for somebody you are losing. While we look at it, that probably you're singing for the time when the goddess is leaving us and going out. It is more probably apt.
It in many angles
right?
Amar
raat pohalo, the night ends as the dawn. As the dawn of Sharod comes.
My
O flute of mine, whom do I entrust you with? Isn't it? I think we are almost done,
almost
right?
Almost done. It has thickened a bit. I'll put two things in it. One is garam masala powder and some
the coriander for garnishing.
Actually, this garam masala powder is optional, basically.
But it's just for the taste
just
and
the
as a taste enhancer, more than that the aroma, right?
And then give it some standing time.
Okay. Yeah, what we'll do is when we give it standing time, we'll cover it up. So that what happens is the
mixes.
Aromas mix up properly and gives it off.
So I'm putting the gas off.
Right, and we'll cover it up, right? So let's first cover it up. And then we go poof.
Yeah.
So
and
we'll
wait
let
for
it
5 minutes.
Right. So I think we are through.
Yeah.
Yeah. So let's. What I'll do first step is I'll do my
granite
tasting with the. Yeah. Exactly. That is exactly what I will do. When I take it off, I'm getting the smell of the garam masala is wafting in. The garam masala that has taken up a little bit of other smells from the puree. And the ginger garlic paste. It's a concoction of the garam masala. That's the principal aroma. And then the ginger garlic thing. Right. So can we go ahead and do a little bit of tasting?
Yeah. Some gravy?
Yes. Please. That's enough. So when we go and try to do this, what we'll do is the usual fare, first try just the gravy.
It's very hot.
When I take the gravy, it's a full-blooded flavor that I'm getting. I'm getting the flavor of garlic, I'm getting the flavor of the condiments, a little bit of tingle from the coriander, a little bit of tingle from the cumin, the garam masala powder is very full bodied in it, and I'm getting the tangy flavor of tomato with a light aftertaste of the sweetness that is there. Now let's try and bite into the curd. You see, it is done properly because it is easily bite tearing off. So it's a fleshy veggie, so obviously it'll take a little bit of cutting, but you can see it doesn't take too much because it has been done very well. So easily come up in two halves, right? So now let's try and have a taste out of that from the stuffing first. When I tried that stuffing, it had its own taste. Now the basic stuffing has taken up the flavors of the gravy also in it. Now when I bite into the curd, let's see what happens. When I bite in, I'm getting the crunch of the shell because it is softened up, but it has not gone completely soft. So it's just there for me to be able to crunch into it, and the stuffing is then pouring out into my palate. So wonderful. And because there was a little bit of seeds into the stuffing made, I'm getting a crunch with every bite that I'm making. Wonderful. Wonderful. A typical Bengali fare, very very delicious, and thanks to the seed, a little bit of a different feel of having it. Wonderful, Tanoya, and thank you so much for this, and thank you for that, for those wonderful words about that song. If you liked the things that we did today, the fun that we had today, our details are downstairs. Do subscribe, do like, share the joy, and if you want to be on this side with me on the Bong Mom's Kitchen, do leave in your details, and we'll get back to you. Until we then, we meet again. And till we meet again, we'll make some more fun in the Bong Mom's Kitchen. Have a wonderful time. Stay safe from the path of Super Cyclone Phoni. Stay safe and cool in this election time. And have a wonderful IPL watching season. Thank you so much.